Hello, my name is Lon Felix. I'm a young Kenyan and a registered voter. Today I wanted to talk to a classmate of mine. Her name is Mary. Mary is my friend on Facebook, like 15,000 other young people that I interact with daily. This morning, I saw a post from Mary saying she is unsure if she is going to vote. Why? Because she does not have faith in the system and the political class has let down her aspirations. I sat with Mary in a law class and perhaps I understand her frustrations just because I am essentially going through the same. But I wanted to talk to her about something. You know, in the last 3 years, I have had the privilege of interacting with our political leaders very closely. First, when working on legislation that were important to me, the first was the Higher Education Loans Board, Loans Board Act, and the second one was the Freedom of Information Bill. And I can tell you for sure, there are political leaders in our country that listen to the people. I have walked to a few of them and they have listened. We have exemplary members of parliament like Ken Okoth who are transforming their constituencies. And so you should never ever give up that there is no reason whatsoever why you should not vote. And let me challenge you. Our democracy is structured in a way that after 5 years, we have an opportunity to evaluate the leadership that we have had. And so instead of giving up after 5 years, this should be a moment of enthusiasm for us young people. If you do not approve of the job that anyone has done, whether it is an MCA, whether it is a governor, whether it is a senator, whether it is the president, this is your time to make your approval be heard. And the only way you can do that is when you are a registered voter and is when you take your time and walk to the poll and cast a ballot on August 8th. When you walk back to your villages, like when I do, walk back to my little village Mukadani back in Buhayo Central in Western Kenya, are you proud with what you see? Are you proud that the road you walked on day, every morning and every evening is still the same and that your younger brothers and cousins are still going to the same school that looks exactly the same way you did? Are you proud that the lack of vision that you grew up with as a young person, where you lacked role models and you never saw something to motivate you, is still what is there even after this devolution? These are the questions that we need to ask. And as young people, we are going to stay in this country for a longer time. And we better stay in a nation where we have participated in the decisions that shape its course. And this is my own persuasion as a young person, that I am going to be very keen on ensuring that my MCA represents my desires, that my governor understands the scale of my vision, that my president understands the aspirations of my country. Every day, as a young person, I interact with my peers who 3 years after school do not have a chance at a decent job or a job at all. Many students in universities do not have opportunities to internships. Many young people do not have an opportunity to access credit so that they can start a small business. As a generation, we have so many challenges facing us. And if the political leadership has a role to play in ensuring that these challenges are resolved, then I am going to determine who becomes my leader. So this is what I want to tell you. Don't give up on the political leadership or the political system. It does not belong to the politicians, it belongs to us. Let this be a moment of enthusiasm. Get out, get registered, and go with a friend. Thank you.